joining us for the fourth installment of our educational video series. I'm Stephanie and this is Prague from B&WTek. Today we're going to be talking about absorption. So Prague, can you tell us a little bit about absorption?
Sure. So when light passes through a material, the first thing that happens is it excites the molecules to either a real or virtual energy state. Now, the energy state that the molecules reach is directly equal to the energy of the photons being absorbed. In spectroscopy, we measure the absorbance as a function of wavelength because the energy of the photons is inversely proportional to the wavelength.
Okay, and what would you use that for?
So take Beer's law, for example. What it states is absorbance is dependent on two properties, the path length of light and the concentration. So given a particular path length, by measuring the absorbance, we can find out what concentrations of your sample you have.
Okay.
So that's exactly what we're going to be measuring today. We have a red dye, which we've diluted to five different concentrations, and we're going to be measuring the absorbance to find out a little bit more about the concentrations we get.
Okay, great. And can you describe the setup that we have here a little more?
Sure. So we start off with a constant current tungsten light source.
Mm-hmm.
The only thing different that we have here is we have a manual attenuator at the front, which lets us regulate the intensity of the light coming out.
Okay, and why would we use this for this video as opposed to the other demonstrations we've done? Okay.
So we have an exemplar plus today, which is the top-of-the-line spectrometer that we make at B&WTek, and this actually has a back-thin, back-illuminated detector. So it's very sensitive. In order not to saturate the detector, we sometimes need to regulate the intensity of light coming out.
Okay.
All of that is attached to a two-port cuvette holder that we have through fiber patch cords, and then again through fiber patch cords directly into the spectrometer.
Okay, so to start off, do we take a dark scan as we've done in the other experiments?
Usually you would, but that's the cool thing about the exemplar technology is that we now have the ability to do automatic dark compensation. So if you go to the hardware setup in the software and click on the spectrometer that's being detected right now, it opens up a window where I can enable the smart scan mode and then check the automatic dark compensation button.
Okay.
Now the cool thing is it also does averaging, or the number of averages. You can determine the number of averages and smoothing. So now you have all these three capabilities built in, and it's doing that as it's collecting the data on board. So since we're doing number of averages on board, that increases the signal-to-noise ratio as well.
Okay, great.
So I think we have a reference sample, which is an empty cuvette, already in there.
Mm-hmm.
So if I just take a quick reference scan, as you can see now, it's gone to zero absorbance.
Okay, so can I go ahead and take the first measurement here?
Sure, why don't you start with the highest concentration.
Okay.
What I'm going to be doing is just taking single acquisitions of each of these five samples,
mm-hmm,
in order to measure the absorbance curve. And since I have the spectrometer on overlay mode, it's showing you all the different intensities as well.
Okay, and why do we have to take so many samples for this one?
Well, one of the reasons is that if you have a unknown compound, what you could do is take all this data that we're measuring and export it to Excel and plot a calibration curve. So if you have an unknown concentration from your calibration curve, then you could determine what concentration it is.
Okay, and so what are some real life applications for this?
So since this is used to measure the concentration of samples, people are using this to measure the different concentrations of RNA or DNA. In chemistry labs, you can use it to analyze the four or five different compounds in a mixture or solution, the different concentrations of the four or five compounds. It might take a little bit more advanced math to separate the signatures, but you could definitely do it, and they use it all the time. This is actually one of the most common applications of spectroscopy. People usually in analytical chemistry call it UV-Vis, but it's nothing but absorption spectroscopy.
Okay, great. Well, thank you so much for your time today. I hope you found this as educational as I did. Be sure to stay tuned for our next video on fluorescence. Thanks.